But from what you're telling me, it sounds like you're doing everything right right now. You're just digging yourself out of a pretty big hole. Welcome to Ask Dr. Gray Pre-Med Q&A. I hope you are doing amazing. How are you today?
I'm good. Yourself? Good.
I'm doing great, thank you. What can I help you with?
Okay, so I'm currently a junior in university. I kind of started over, so I'm technically a non-traditional student since I
Okay.
started over. And I'm, just wanted some advice on how to, deal with the craziness of all of it and trying to, hit those. I know you say often don't try to hit all those boxes,
Yep.
but when you don't have a lot of clinical experience, and my GPA, because of that time frame that I had to take off, it took a hit freshman year. So I'm starting over. So my GPA is going up. Like I'm also a subscriber to MAPPD,
Mapped.
the platform. Math.
Yeah,
Yes.
we say it mapped. It's an acronym, not an and it's not an acronym. It's just a name. It's not any sort of
Okay.
abbreviation.
So yeah, I'm subscribed to that. So I see the trend. I
Good.
see like a positive trend
Good.
on mine. But I'm also, trying to get like a certification as well, for LPN or LVN, whichever depends on the state that you are in, to, get some clinical experience, because I don't have that right now. I work in a hospital, but I'm an assistant administrator, so
Okay.
I don't have a lot of patient interaction
Yeah.
as I used to.
Yeah. Well, it's good that you recognize that, right? Just because you're in a hospital setting doesn't make that clinical experience. So good on you for recognizing that and going out and searching for something else. But let's talk about a little bit more of the journey because it sounds like you are more in a situation where you're just lacking a lot of confidence because of your initial struggles and where you're at now. But from what you're telling me, it sounds like you're doing everything right now. You're just digging yourself out of a pretty big hole. Is that right?
Yeah, that's pretty much it. So, I was like really high up in high school. Like I was top 10 of my class in high school. So, and I did a lot of dual enrollment. I did a lot of college classes in high school. So by the time I did graduate high school, I, felt some type of way of myself. I was up, I felt high above myself. So I got overly confident when I went to university, and I, the whole university setting is a completely different animal. And I thought, yeah, I could do this. I was doing it in high school. I was juggling both, but with some personal stuff that I had to deal with, family, and I had to start working, it was hard to, balance going to school and doing, trying to meet those prereqs. So when freshman year ended, I was in a mid-level hole. So
What
I
was your
thought it had,
GPA after freshman year?
it was at a 2.0.
Okay.
It wasn't bad. But when I did go into sophomore year, I thought I'll just, I'll recover. But no, it just, for things in my dad got sick, so I had to work more. I, had to work more and try to like help my mom, help my dad, help my sister. So unfortunately, school kind of took more of the hit. So then by the time I ended sophomore year, my GPA was at a 1 point something that I don't remember right now. So I took a year off, did, I'm like, I can't keep digging myself into a hole. So what I did was I, prioritize school. I said, I can't do this anymore. So I went, started over, took a year off, dealt with whatever I need to deal with my family. And I went back to community college. I couldn't go back to the university setting because I couldn't do a full-time schedule anymore. So because I was still working. So then I went to community college, did that. So I'm back at a university. I'm going to FIU now. I know my limits. now, which before just more of a learning curve, like, hey, you can't be doing 12 classes in, you know, per year and then expect them to all do well.
Yeah.
I was taking, because the prereqs are like WEDOC courses, unfortunately. Yep. So I did that and I'm doing better, but it's a matter of digging myself out of that hole.
Yeah. Are you getting as close to a 4.0 as possible at this point?
Yes, I am.
Okay.
It's taking a lot because I'm still working full time, and because of COVID, my hours have been more ridiculous at the hospital. Because my job has become from just being assistant admin to doing everybody else's job. I even done medical assisting at one point and phlebotomy. So I have a little bit, but it's just not. It's just me covering. It's just not. It's not something I could put into an application, say, hey, I'm doing this, but it's not really what I'm actually doing. It's just a matter, they need help, I'm jump in and do whatever I have to do.
It's still clinical experience. I would still put it on your application.
Okay.
I wouldn't leave it off just because that's not your technical job title. If you're doing it, great, put it in there. It's very common to have kind of two activity spots for the same job that are covering very different experiences. So I wouldn't worry about that. My biggest concern is you going from struggling in university to taking a break, coming back to community college, doing well, going back to university, doing well, but still with all of this other stuff going on that potentially could derail you at any moment. Now, yes. Obviously, you need to do what you need to do in terms of work and putting a roof over your head and food on the table and all of that stuff. But are you at a point where you're pretty confident that your trend is going to stay where it's at? You've figured out the time management and organizational stuff. You've figured out the study habits to do well in school. Are you at that point where you're comfortable with the workload and everything else?
So what I've been doing is that I have been taking it a little more easier with the reference to the number of classes that I'm taking. Mm. So I'm not taking I'm doing part-time at school.
Okay.
So I'm doing full-time at work.
Okay.
So the classes that I'm taking, it's not like I'm taking like physics or organic chemistry. I'm taking more like a psychology class, say English class, to try to get myself back on the rhythm of school.
Okay.
And I already made it a point, and I spoke with my parents as well, that when I feel ready to go full time, that I will quit my job to be full time.
Great.
At school, and then any clinical experience that I have to do would be just out on the weekends or in the afternoons and evenings.
Yeah. Perfect.
That would be more manageable.
Awesome.
But for right now, because I am still working, I'm doing it an easier load from school. So I maintain that a high GPA that I'm, you know, trying to trend for.
Yeah. That's okay. that's your journey. That's okay. And some schools may not like that longer drawn out journey and taking the time off and taking a little bit easier course load right now. And that's okay. There are going to be plenty of schools that are okay with it and understand that journey.
Yeah. So sometimes I feel, you know, a little bit on the downside because I do have friends who are almost done and are taking the MCAT. They're, you
who
know,
cares about them?
Doing the applications.
Who cares about
and all
them?
That.
Who cares about them?
I'm putting the blindfold on, but it becomes a little hard.
It is hard. It is hard, but it's the race that you're running, and it is what it is. So the more you think about them doing their thing, the more discouraged you're going to get, and the more at risk you will be of falling down a deeper hole. So you just have to be thankful and be thankful that you're on your journey and you're being successful now, and be happy for them that they're on their journey and just keep running your race.
Yeah. I did have one question though.
Yeah.
I've considered like a post back in, you know, just thinking about, cause there's some of the prereqs that I did freshman and on sophomore year, I'm going to have to retake. I've realized that I'm going to have to retake them. But where I'm at right now, because I'm already a junior, I can't really go back and take the prereqs again.
Why not?
Something with I don't know if it's the way that my advisor said that, oh, no, you can't, you can't, because there's like a subcharge or something like that, that I have to pay out of pocket. So I was thinking if I can do a post bac to try to, once I graduate, to do those prereqs, or I'm not really sure.
Yeah, it really depends on the institution and the kind of way that they handle retakes. And did you fail the class versus you just got a low grade and you want to retake it? Every school is going to be a little bit different with how they handle it. So it sounds like potentially at your school, they want you to maybe pay a retake fee. It sounds like, and so that may be cheaper than going and doing a quote unquote post bac, where you're just taking the same class at a different institution and not necessarily signing up for a formal post bac. Obviously, a formal post bac is going to be much more expensive than any sort of retake fee that your institution is going to charge you. And so you just have to do the math and look around at different schools in your area. I probably at this point would not go to a community college to do the extra work that you need to do, because that may just look a little bit weird, going from the four-year university, struggling, going to community college, going back to the four-year university, doing well, and then going back to community college for your prereqs. I probably would recommend staying at a four-year institution to do that, just so there are no questions later on. Mm-hmm. And just seeing what institutions are in your area that would work out. And if there's nothing, then you may just have to pay that extra fee.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that was just something I was wondering, because I've seen, you know, different people on your podcast that have done the post bac to try to improve the GPAs and all that. And I feel like I'm doing okay in reference to my GPA, how it's looking. But, you know, I want to have like a bit of a safety net just in case when I get to that point when I have to do the application.
Yeah. Yeah, and really where you are with your journey, a post bac could just mean you graduate because you have enough credits to do it, and then you just continue to take classes at your institution. And that technically is a post bac, just with the language that by definition of what a post bac is.
Okay, yeah, that's just that. And, you know, I've been looking at different schools. A lot of the schools that you have on your podcast, I've, you know, got more drawn into. Like at one point I was looking at UM and UF and then Nova, but the two that standing out the most after hearing them on your podcast was Nova and UF.
Yeah.
So I'm really grateful for that I found your podcast a little bit late, but I'm happy that I found it now.
You found them. Well, good. Mm-hmm. It sounds like you're doing everything you need to be doing. Just trust yourself and continue on this journey and continue working hard and doing well, and you'll be all right.
Thank you. I appreciate it.